Hi, it's Vicky here and welcome to another card making video. Today I'm going to use my own dies, the winter set that I designed for Spellbinders, and I will combine it with the foiling kit of this month by Spellbinders. So these are the plates that are included. You will find three decorative plates as well as a couple of dies that cut out that curve. And you will also find a couple of sentiments that you can foil that fit lovely along that curve. So I will start by doing the foiling first. I'm going to use the lovely decorative plate that has all those Christmas flowers on top. And I'm using this handy little tool to cut out my foil without using the top. This allows me to make a curve following the design. And I'm going to keep the rest so that I can do some foiling on sentiments later on. I just don't throw anything. I'm quite frugal with my foiling. I'm working on a red cardstock here that's 4.25 by 5.5. I'm placing the plate on top of the foiling and securing everything down with some washi tape just to make sure that nothing is going to move as I transfer the platform to the die cutting machine. I press the button and you can see that light flashing. I have to wait until this stops. That means that the plate is nicely warmed and it can do its job. Now at this stage I could have gone and foiled the sentiment at the same time, but I didn't plan ahead. I wasn't sure of what I'm going to do, so I will have to foil this piece of cardstock twice. And of course the most satisfying part is when you peel off the foiling and see what's there. It was absolutely perfect, no overfoiling at all. And of course, since I didn't do it in the first step, I have to do it now. I place the plate that says Merry Christmas along that curve. It's nicely nested. And then I'm going to add some golden foil again and do the same technique. But definitely you can do that in one step. I just wasn't thinking in the beginning of what I want to do. And it's stunning. I absolutely love foiling, it's such a lovely detail on any card. Now I'm going to use the die that matches that curve at the bottom and I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine. And you see I'm taking my time to align it correctly to make sure that it's going to follow the curve nicely. Run it through your die cutting machine and it's going to give you a lovely decorative edge. Now grab any Christmas pattern paper that you have. If it has a little bit of red that matches the red of your cardstock, then it's even better. I decided to go with this one. This is from a pad by My Favorite Things. The card already looks stunning as it is. However, I'm going to take it a step further. I used one of the dies from the set that gives you that decorative edge that has scallop details. And of course it follows the same curve. So I'm going to stick it underneath and it's going to give a lovely definition to that curve so that it stands out even better. I'm going to add some foam tape at the back, stick it on top of my pattern paper. And of course you can call this card done, but let's take it a step further and make it more beautiful. For that I'm bringing in my birdhouse. This is the winter one from my birdhouses collection that I designed for Spellbinders. And I'm going to use only the mistletoe branches as well as the poinsettia. Just because this die set does have a big birdhouse doesn't mean that you have to use it every time you grab the set. I designed the set making sure that beside that big birdhouse that you get, you also get little dies that can be used on pretty much every holiday card to embellish it. So you get mistletoe, poinsettias, holly berries, a little bell, bow, you get so many things to play with. I cut out two poinsettias out of white cardstock, offset one on top of the other to make it look fuller, and I'm embellishing the flower by adding some of those mistletoe branches as well as a golden gem at the center. Now I'm also going to bring in a few more of these branches. I made sure to cut them out from a different color of cardstock just to make it look fuller. And I am planning to do some embellishing with my Nouveau Drops, but I will leave it as a final step when I finish the second card. So I will come back to it later on. So let's move on and make a second card using this set and you will see close-up photos at the end. Now I did cut out that big birdhouse out of white cardstock and this is going to be my focal point, and I also cut it out from golden cardstock so that I could separate the roof and stick one on top of the other to embellish it a little bit more. I'm using one of the foiling plates that has a lovely decorative design on a piece of white cardstock. This is 3.5 in width, if you want to know the exact measurements. And at the same time, I'm going to do the foiling of the sentiment that I'm going to use for this card. Then from the foiling set, I'm going to bring the die that cuts out that decorative edge. It follows that scallop design and it fits perfectly underneath. Now the sentiment comes from the Holiday Sentiments. This is a set from last year, designed by Yana Smakula. Definitely one of my favorites. I love the writing as well as that it comes with dies that cuts out all these sentiments. And I have all the elements that I need for my card ready. Let's put it together. I have a dark green cardstock that's 3.5 by 4.75. In the finished card, I want to have that birdhouse nested somehow in the curve. That's why I'm temporarily holding everything together so that I know exactly where I want to cut. I'm using the die from the foiling kit and I'm going to cut out both the green cardstock as well as the decorative edge. Now I know that this white piece is going to fit lovely underneath. It's going to give some contrast, and to enhance that contrast even more, I brought in my Black Suit Distress ink and I'm inking up the edges. Darkening up the edges of an otherwise dark cardstock is a great technique and it always brings your card into the next level. You can either do that with dark green or you can go black like I did here. And now, just like I did for the first card, I'm going to stick that decorative white edge underneath. It's going to embellish my top panel. And I do have a leftover from the previous card that I made using that pattern paper. I'm not throwing anything away. I'm going to use it for this one. So I will stick it down. And again, I'm working on a white piece of paper that's 3.5 by 4.75. If you follow my videos, you know that I absolutely love pattern paper. I want to use the pattern paper that I have. I don't hoard it. I just do my best to turn it into cards, and there are so lovely designs out there. Now it's time to stick the birdhouse on top, again by using foam tape at the back, and it's one of my favorite birdhouses that I designed. I made sure that it looks like a droplet, and since it's my design, I'm allowed to say that it's super cute and adorable. Plus, it works for any occasion. You can decorate it with snow, you can decorate it with flowers, you can use it for Valentine's Day since it has that heart die for the window. For this card, I'm using the Holly Berries. There is a die that cuts out that leaf as well as the little dots. I did cut out the leaves from green cardstock, the dots from red cardstock, and of course, you can omit using the die cut dots. Use sequins instead, or gems, or even enamel dots. You can use your nouveau drops, so many ideas. Those two leaves and the few red berries really can turn any card into a Christmas looking one. It is one of those dies that you can use again and again every year. Now I'm using thin strips of foam tape at the back of the sentiment and I will stick it on top of the birdhouse. I decided not to use a birdie for this card. I'm keeping it simple. I think it looks beautiful and it doesn't need a bird. Of course, if you do have the bird die set, you can definitely add a little birdie standing on top of the sentiment. And here are both the cards that I made for today. I'm going to finish them off with nouveau drops. This is usually a step that I leave for the end so that I don't make a mess and touch them by accident. I did add glitter on the berries. And on this card, I'm adding some dots here and there. There are already dots along that lovely border. So I'm just following that design and I will add a few of those white dots on top of the mistletoe to look like the white berries. And in my winter dies, you will find also dies that cut out those white berries, but I decided to use the nouveau drops instead. So here are some close-up photos on the two cards that I made for today. Just like always, down below in the description area, you will find links to everything I used. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to click like as well as leave me a comment. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.